After months in the making, the long-awaited album from Ken Roberts is finally complete. The album titled Final Mix features 11 original songs by Ken Roberts. Not bad for a guy who doesn't necessarily read music.
It was interesting, you know, to go in and lay down a guitar track and just have a piece of paper there with words on it, and then remember when I went back to sing it that I had to remember where I put the lead, or where I left room for a lead guitar or an instrumental or things like that. And but God was good, and he just allowed me to, I think, just to go in and lay down all the tracks in one day. But I had to go back one other day and mix down three songs. But, 11 songs in one day was quite a bit. But we did get through it, and it was just a wonderful time.
On a cold October night, recently we spoke to Ken at his home in Windsor. And as he lay in a hospital bed set up in his living room, a weakened but not defeated Ken Roberts talked openly about the new album and how it has fulfilled a lifelong dream.
Well, my whole purpose for doing this cassette, one, it's a dream come true. You know, it really is a dream come true. I don't know if you have enough money nowadays, you can take your songs. Anybody can and do it. But I would like to be able to minister to people, you know, and I'm just hopeful that through the words that God has given me over the years, that I know these aren't going to minister to everybody, but I'm sure if it ministers to one or two here or two or three there, and so that's my ultimate goal, is to, you know, was to minister to people. And I'm at a point where I can't go out and do road shows.
As I rode along the highway, the sun began to set, and the yellow seemed to melt into blue. I felt my soul rise as I gave you my thoughts, as if doing a favor for you. Then my soul rejoiced as I realized that without you I'd never be free. And long before I thought of you, my Lord, you thought of me. I watched my babies come into the world and take their very first breath. And I know of many who were born again and saved from certain death. And I thought of you as if thinking of you would fulfill some almighty need. But long before I thought of you, my Lord, you thought of me. It took some time to realize, it took some time to long before I love you, my Jesus, you love me.
Thank you.
making its way across a grassy field. And I noticed a meadow with its flowers in bloom, and pretty soon their fruit they would yield. And I thought of you, and as I thought of you, I realized this truth humbly, that long before I thought of you, took some time to realize, it took some time to see, that long before I loved you, my Jesus, you loved me. As I rode along the highway, and the sun began, and the yellows seem to melt into blue.
From his brand new album, Final Mix, a song titled You Thought of Me, Ken Roberts. Upon the completion of his new album, Ken says he feels like a kid with a new toy.
I finally get my songs down, and, you know, and now what do I do now that they're down? You know, but God just orchestrated that and brought so many, you know, Christian brothers and sisters in to help on aspects that I'm just not talented in. You know, I can strum my guitar and sing a few notes, but it took all the other people pulling together, you know, banjo and strings and bass and vocals, and, you know, to pull this all together. But it was an exciting feeling.
Come, let us reason together. Come, let us reason together. Says the Lord. Come, let us reason together. Come, let us reason together. Say, your sins are like scarlet, they shall be whiter than snow. Though they are red as crimson, they shall be as wool. For I will restore health unto thee, and I will heal thee of thy wounds, saith the Lord. So come, let us reason together. Come, let us reason together. I will heal thee of thy wounds, saith the Lord.
Ken Roberts, and Come Let Us Reason Together. Another song from Ken's new album is one he also wrote, titled I'm Not Ashamed.
Well, you know, I started writing this song because I liked the tune, because I was fooling around in a, with the key of E, and just with an E and an open E, and I was just going up and down the neck, and I had been fooling around with it and saying I'm not ashamed, and just started looking through God's Word, you know, and ran across, you know, ran across Romans, you know, where we just, where that scripture verse is. And then I just started building on it. I think we can all say, you know, I felt like, well, I'm ashamed of this gospel. And, but I've got no reason to be ashamed of it.
I am not ashamed, I'm not ashamed, I'm not ashamed of the gospel. I'm not ashamed to stand up and proclaim. I'm not ashamed of the gospel. And verse 16, God's word stands true for all to see that we are not to be ashamed. The power of God's alive today, salvation it can come your way if you are willing to believe. Yes, salvation you receive when down upon a bended knee we give our hearts and souls to Jesus. Confess your sin now unto him and he will let you enter in. Don't be ashamed of Jesus Christ. That's why I am not ashamed. I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed of this gospel. I am not ashamed to stand up and proclaim. I'm not ashamed of this gospel. Every man, to all who will accept this gospel. I'll tell you, friend, you just can't lose. The battle's won, there's no more blues. Don't be ashamed of this gospel. But the world tells you it's found a way. The world says that it's okay, and you can do it by yourself. But hear the truth, that's just a lie. The gospel stands the test of time. No, it will never be denied. That's why I am not ashamed. I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed of this gospel. I am not ashamed to stand up and proclaim. I'm not ashamed of this gospel. That's right, I am not ashamed. Not ashamed. I'm not ashamed of the gospel. So don't you be ashamed, just stand up and proclaim. Together we'll proclaim this gospel.
Ken Roberts shouting it loud and clear with I'm Not Ashamed. Ken's own personal walk has proven that he is not ashamed of the gospel. In fact, as he's been in and out of the hospital for cancer treatment over the last year, Ken's faith in God has continued to shine through.
You know, God's given me some boldness, I guess. More than I'm not a real, real bold person. I just love people. But it's given me some boldness when I go into the hospital. It's like, well, they can't talk about Jesus, and the doctors don't, and the nurses don't, and yet there's Christians there. And but I can put my verses up and wear my baseball cap and let them know that where my faith and my hope is, and it's found in that. Like I said, back again, I don't need to be ashamed of the gospel. You know, I wonder and I scratch my head sometimes as to why I'm going through what I'm going through, and I don't like it. I don't like the circumstances at all. But that no other place to turn to that shows me that they have any other hope or any other answers either. And I'd rather be safe in my Father's arms than just out there leaning on an old dead branch, you know, hanging over the edge of a cliff somewhere, thinking that maybe something's going to catch me. I know if I fall now, I'm going to fall into the arms of my Father. And He's going to catch me.
For God so loved the world, He gave His only Son, that who believes in Jesus Christ will have eternal life. I once was lost, but now I'm found, blind, but now I for He who lives in Jesus Christ will have eternal life. For God so loved the world, He gave His only Son, that who believes in Christ will have eternal life. By grace you have been saved through faith, not of yourself. For He who lives in Jesus Christ will have eternal life.
Ken Roberts and Friends, and Eternal Life. Ken also included on his new album a song that's become his theme song over the years and is actually his own testimony put to music, simply called The Yodel Song.
What my friend Bob Vigno did was took where I grew up and some of my life up before that point and that I did grow up in the back hills of Vermont and in a small town and no theaters or restaurants, and we just went on through, and there was a time that I lived on the Bartlett farm and as Toby Bartlett reminded me, she said there were times she'd step out her door and hear me yodeling in the barn because I'd yodel over the phone to somebody.
Well, I grew up in the back hills of Vermont, in a little town without a theater or a restaurant. And I'd listen to the songs on the radio. To be a cowboy singing star was my dream and goal. Well, I'd beat on the chairs and I'd hit in the pots and pans. When there was nothing to hit, I would sit and just clap my hands. A piano or a guitar I could never afford. And then one fine summer I received a gift from the Lord. It was the funniest thing, it was a song without any words. And who'd believe I would sing such a thing in church? But for that matter, who would ever believe that Jesus Christ had a definite plan for me? Well, now the Lord, he wanted everything that I had. But he gave back the good and he crucified the bad. I was a little surprised, but let me tell you, I was pleased that the Lord saw fit to give the yodel back to me. So I'd yodel at work and I'd yodel on my way home. And at night I'd call up my friends and yodel over the phone. And then sometimes I'd just yodel cause I was bored. But I'm also thankful I could still yodel for the Lord.
Ken Roberts' favorite from his new album Final Mix, The Yodel Song. Another upbeat and playful song with a biblical message is a song Ken wrote several years ago called Clay.
That was like a testimony, and I just found a verse in Isaiah 64, I think it is, where it talks about the potter and the clay, you know, and can the clay make itself? And it can't, it has to wait for the potter. And I don't know, I felt like all these songs I've kind of tried to pull out and use myself as a guideline. I use my Christian walk or parts of my Christian walk as guidelines or areas that I need to work on and improve. And I don't have all the words, but when I think back on the times of how I used to be, you know, a man of indecision, but I was blind and couldn't see. And because I didn't know, you know, I was thinking of the times when I was a young teenager, I didn't know, you know, Jesus Christ is my Savior and Lord. And I didn't know the love that he had for me. And but now, you know, the chorus goes, all I want to be is a piece of clay shaped and molded by my Savior's hand. You know, and I tried some things that the world had. You know, not a lot of things, you know. fortunately, he kept me out of drugs and alcohol, but I tried the fast cars and, you know, and the wanting motorcycles and material things. Just to be a piece of clay, shaped and molded, you know, it's like another little testimony, you know, that's all I want to be, just a little piece of clay shaped and molded by my Savior's hand.
When I think back on the time of how I used to be, a man of indecision, but I was blind and could not see, for I knew not my Savior's ways or the love he had for me. And I knew not that I could be made whole in my Jesus made complete. And all I want to be is a piece of clay to be shaped completely by my Savior's hand. Well, I tried some things the world gave free, but the world had strings attached to me. I thought there has to be a better way, but I wondered who could set me free. And then one day into my life, I found my Savior Jesus Christ. He took my sorrow and he took my sin. Now I can fully count on him. And all I want to be is a piece of clay to be shaped completely by my Savior's hand. Shaped and molded every day, I want to be a vessel used by God and help the lost come to the Lord. We must be shaped by Jesus' hand. We gotta listen to him and not mortal man. He has the answers that we all seek for, and he holds the key to every door. And all by my Savior's hand. All I want to be is a piece of clay to be shaped completely by my Savior's hand.
With Chuck Hunsinger on banjo, it's Ken Roberts, a song called Clay.
You know, but a Christian brother stepped through the door of my hospital room, and it's like I'm sitting here talking to you. God was talking to me real quick and real fast, and like a parent saying, before I can do any further work, in your life, you've got to ask this brother for his forgiveness. You need to ask him if he will forgive you. I needed to ask him if he would forgive me. He said to me, what do I need to, you know, to forgive you for? And I said, remember back when we had a little tiff, and, you know, and then we came back together, and I said everything was fine, and you said everything was fine, and you probably meant it, and I'm sure you did, otherwise you wouldn't have said it. And I said it, but I really didn't mean it, because I still hung on to a grudge, and I didn't let go of it. And so I need to ask you to forgive me for hanging on to that grudge, for not letting go of it back when I should have let go of it, because that was the time, and that's how bitterness and gossip and envy and strife settle in. And they forgave me, and we had a great visit. And it wasn't but a couple days after that, Dan, that right here on my couch, I had another brother come and do the very same thing to me, ask me to forgive them. And I said, you're forgiven. You know, life is sometimes too short to go along holding grudges. And, you know, just worrying about those kind of things. And so from that, I sat here on the couch and started thinking, what matters? Do the tools that I have in my garage that I've built up over the years matter? Do the guitars that I have, you know, and all the toys and the clocks and the little cupboards and the shelves and the things that I've made matter? They're all going to get burned up. The motorcycle that I have, it's all going to get rusted and corroded and trashed. What's going to matter in the end? What's really going to matter is that personal, you know, person's relationships with people, you know, building into people, you know, having that friendship there, having, you know, just reaching out and being able to have relationships instead of things.
Broken and bent, ripped up and torn, falling apart at the seams, trying my hardest to pick up the pieces. Oh Lord, show me just what this means. Was I misunderstood? Was I holding a grudge? I thought I knew just what to do. And then Jesus showed me just how hard my heart was. Oh Lord, show me what I must do. And I know now that things just don't matter. Relationships, that's what must be. And I know now that more than ever before, that toys aren't the answer for me. When I finally let go of the things I love so, and I laid them before Jesus' feet, then he started healing those broken relations. Praise God, that means so much to me. God's word showed that clearly to me. Slow down on your projects, seek God and He'll show you relationships that's what must be. Broken and bent, if you're ripped up and torn, and you're falling apart at the seams, just reach out to Jesus, He holds all the answers, relationships, that's what must be. That's what must be. Relationships, that's what must be.
Ken Roberts from his new album Final Mix and Relationships. Ken's relationship to his wife Marie is a subject of one of the songs on his new album.
The Rest of Our Lives started as a, to be honest, as a song that I was going to write for somebody else, you know, and but I used the marriage that God had given my wife and I as the background for it, and I kept just drawing implications from the different points in my life, you know, that my wife and I, that God had ministered to my wife and I through the years, you know. You know, God brings a couple together for, you know, and those words, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, you know. When it gets down to where the road gets rough, when you're going through a tough time, that's when, you know, your marriage starts either showing that it's working or that it's not. And for me, I've got to say, I have a Proverbs woman. God has given me and blessed me with a Proverbs wife, a Proverbs 31 wife. And she's just been, you know, so supportive and there if I needed her at any time. And so I ended up just drawing from that part of it, just drawing from all the aspects that God had brought us through and brought us together.
Today begins the first day of the rest of our lives, as we are standing here as husband and wife. And as I look upon you with tears in my eyes, these words I speak to you are true. I will always love you, I will never leave, I am bound to you forevermore. And though we may have trials and troubles come our way, the foundation of our love is in the Lord. Now these vows I make before you, I make with all my heart.
God's word has shown me clearly that from them I can't part. I left my childhood home and I cleave to you alone. So may the two of us always be one. For better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, I vow that I will always stand by you. In sickness and in health, till death do us part, my love for you. I will always love you, I will never leave, I am bound to you forevermore. And though we may have trials and troubles come our way, the foundation of our love is in the Lord.
A song dedicated to his wife, Marie. Ken Roberts with The Rest of Our Lives. Man's blindness to sin around him is a theme of a song Ken wrote called Blinded Eyes.
I believe that the enemy, who is Satan, has blinded the eyes of the people and not allowed them to see the wonderful benefits that Christ offers us. You know, and that's one reason I wrote Blinded Eyes was, I was driving down the streets of Windsor and just seemed like that everybody was doing their own thing, walking their own way, and yet really not going, not saying that they had to go to church, but, you know, missing that personal relationship that they can have with Jesus.
Went to the doctor's this morning. He said my eyes are doing fine. An expression that we've all heard from time to time. Yet we walk our streets and we go to church like we do most all of our lives. Yet we refuse to see what we ought to see because we see through blinded eyes. Blinded eyes, oh, blinded eyes. Well, I know my Lord in heaven, he cries and he cries. Blinded eyes, oh, blinded eyes. And as each day draws us nearer to that goal, our heavenly prize, may the Lord and God be real to you and open up those blinded eyes. Look inside your home, is your TV set turned on? If Jesus came into your living room, would you leave your about the place that you work, with all the things that you do and say. Put Jesus first into your life, because there is no other way. Blinded eyes, oh, blinded eyes. Well, I know my Lord in heaven, he cries and he cries. Blinded eyes, oh, blinded eyes. And as each day draws us nearer to that goal, our heavenly prize, may the Lord and God be real to you and open up those blinded eyes. Bible's taught and God is alive. Then we as man get in the way and God's plan is minimized. Yet as for me, I've got one prayer. It's for all of us to realize that Jesus is the only one. He'll open up those blinded eyes. Blinded eyes, oh, blinded eyes. Goal, our heavenly prize. May the Lord and God be real to you and open up those blinded eyes. Blinded eyes, oh, blinded eyes. Well, I know my Lord in heaven, he cries and he cries. Blinded eyes, oh, blinded eyes. Goal, our heavenly prize. May the Lord and God be real to you and open up those blinded eyes. These blinded eyes.
Ken Roberts and Blinded Eyes. Well, now that the album project is finished, Ken says he hopes the songs will encourage others, no matter what circumstances they find themselves in.
Just to keep hanging in there and walking a daily walk, because that's all my wife and I have done. I don't know how to do anything else but that. But just to walk daily and take it one day at a time and not to plan too far in advance, because things change. Everything's subject to change. And I'm still trying to figure out why me, you know. But what this has done, it has just opened up the door, you know. This sickness that I'm fighting has given me such an opportunity to witness, you know, and to open our mouths and to encourage a lot of folks. Folks that are going through it, I don't have to tell them how it hurts and how it feels. They know how it feels. But God has taught me to, and I'm still working on it, not to holler and scream and yell at my kids quite so much. And that it's not going to do any good to get the ones around you upset. Because if you get the ones around you upset, then where's your support? You know, I mean, not that you get your support first from the Lord, but and second from your family. But if I don't have my family there supporting me, man, I'd be lost. I also hope that it reaches out to my family and ministers to them. I just really wanted to minister to my brothers and sisters, you know, because they've been watching me over the past 20 years, 20 some odd years since I've been a Christian, you know, and first ones, you know, to look at you or to scrutinize you, usually it's your family. And I love my family, and all I want my family to know is that, you know, God loves you and has a wonderful plan for your life, you know. And I just want them, you know, maybe to listen to this tape and hear something off in one of these songs that reaches down and touches them and brings them a little closer to the Lord. I just hope that people are, you know, they're encouraged. I hope they can laugh. I hope they have fun with the yodel. You know, I hope if they're thinking about writing a testimony, that there'll be a song on here that'll give them maybe ideas on, you know, what is my testimony? How can I share my testimony? I just hope that from I'm not ashamed all the way down to relationships, you know, it's a tape that will hit somebody along the way somewhere. One of these songs here somewhere will minister to their lives, you know, and just realize that they need to get a relationship back together. Maybe not be so afraid to share the gospel. Doesn't mean they have to get a banner and necessarily run up and down the street saying, you know, you must be saved, you must be saved. But on the other hand, when that time comes when someone insults the name of the Lord, not to be afraid to speak up and say, wait a second, that's my Lord you're talking about. That's my Savior. And I still struggle with that, you know. I don't always, you know, speak out as much as I should. Sometimes I feel I should speak out more. But, and I just hope it's enjoyed and enjoyable, and wouldn't be possible without all the help and the support from all the Christian friends. And Christian friends and non-Christian friends, you know, I don't mean to categorize here, but all the people that have just donated time and love and money and gifts on this, you know, so, and it's been great.
There are many roads on which you will travel, many highways in your life you go, and there will be some that you'll not understand, if only to know which way to go. And there'll be some times in your life the way you went was really right. But if you just stick to those narrow roads, you can't miss what God has for your life. There are roads that cross the highest mountains, roads that tunnel under deepest seas, and roads that travel through the hottest deserts, and through the deepest forest and the trees. But someday into your life may come a road on which you can't turn from, and
and it's called The Crossroads of Your Life. That's where you find the Savior, Jesus Christ. 'Cause if you stand at the crossroads of your life, not knowing which road to choose, you can stand firm on Christ and be grounded in Him. For down God's road you can never lose. God, my friend, you cannot lose. If you let Him direct your life, you'll see. But if you take your eyes off Jesus, the road becomes as rocky as can be. For the world will tempt you with all its things, but that road is a dead end. All that glitters is not gold, my friend. The narrow roads will keep you safe in Him. 'Cause if you stand at the crossroads of your life, not knowing which road to choose, you can stand firm on Christ and be grounded in Him. For down God's road you can never lose. Yes, down God's road.
Ken Roberts in a song called Crossroads. And you've been listening to the new Ken Roberts album soon to be released called Final Mix. This is Dan Parker. Thanks for listening.